Be like me. Now, mimi picha meno yangu ni ngumu sana. And people see me by the teeth. Bwana asifiwe.
Amen.
I'm glad to be alive today, a day God has given us to share His word. Nimefurahi kuona wageni, nimefurahi kuona mama ya basi. I've only heard of her, I've never seen her. So nimefurahi kumwona. So nikiona uso wa basi ninaona mama yake. Bwana asifiwe. Nimefurahi pia kuona baba Hope. Mungu awabariki sana. Karibuni, mmekaribishwa kwa jina la Yesu. Tunafuraha kwamba tuko mbele ya Bwana wetu Yesu Kristo aliye na sababu katika maisha yetu. And we are here to accomplish as He accomplishes His purpose in our lives. Bwana asifiwe. Are you happy yourself to be in the presence of the Lord? It's good to be in the presence of the Lord because we learn from Him and He teaches us many things to make our lives so interesting and enjoyable as we journey to heaven. Bwana asifiwe.
Amen.
Sisi maisha yetu haishi hapa, sio? We are only pilgrims. We are passing by. We are on transit. Tunaenda kwa baba. Tunarudi nyumbani. So mimi narudi nyumbani. Niko tayari kwenda nyumbani hata saa hii. So tarumbeta ikilia saa hii, mimi niko ready. Wanasema niko ngangari, Niko ngangari kwenda. I don't know about you. I asked somebody, niliuliza mtu during the week, ikamuliza, are you ready to go home? Kaniuliza, which home? Ambia, home is heaven. Are you ready? And then you know what he told me? Ikiwa ni mapenzi ya Mungu. My friend, it is already the will of God. But to end what? Yes, it's already the will of God. And that's why He has sent us to preach the gospel to every creature. It is His will. And the scripture says that He suffers no one to get lost. Hataki yeyote apotee. Hivyo ndivyo anavyosema katika neno lake. That everybody, if it is possible, everybody, any human being He created, should enter heaven. That is God's will. So it is His will that you go to heaven. But the choice is made by you and you yourself. As an individual, you make a choice. That's why the scripture anasema, choose life and live. Mwaisoma ya kitabu cha Kumbukumbu la Torati mlango wa 11 aya 27 anasema, choose life and live. Bwana asifiwe. So those who choose life will live. Those who do not choose life will die. Bwana asifiwe. So I say I will never die. Don't wait for my death, please. Because I'll never die. Bwana asifiwe. What does the scripture say? Those who believe in Christ have passed from death to life. So they'll never die again. So I'll not die. Don't wait for the day I die. Because I will not. Bwana asifiwe. I'll only do what? If the Lord tarries, I'll only sleep. Nitalala tu usingizi. Then when the trumpet sounds, I'll be woken up. And I'll meet Him in the clouds. Bwana asifiwe.
Amen.
That is who the Lord is. And He's really willing that we go to heaven. So you don't say if it is the willing of God for me to go to heaven. It is His will that you go to heaven. But the choice is made by you. And by now you should be sure that you are going. Bwana asifiwe. Are you sure that you are going to heaven?
Yes.
Aye. You should be sure, because the Spirit of God testifies with our hearts that we belong to God. So if the Spirit of God lives in you, He testifies with your heart that you belong to God. So you have nothing to fear. Kama tarubele taria sahi, utageuka nyuma useme, hey, goja! And say, Lord, have you come? Let's go home. Then the Lord receives you home. Bwana asifiwe. Bwana asifiwe. I love it. I tell you, I love it. And I tell you, through any suffering, kija, do not give up. Don't give up. Hold on. Hold on to the cross of Jesus Christ. Hold on. Hold on, because He is coming to take us home. And the book of Revelation chapter 21, soma hapo verse 1 up to verse 6 hapo, takuna nasema ata Bwana atayafuta machozi na hasara. Napenda wimbo. Mungu atayafuta machozi na hasara, nayo miaka itakoma hapa na usiku. Mungu atayafuta machozi na hasara, na hatutahesabu miaka tena ati niko age this and that. Watu wengine hawataki kujulikana age yao. Lisa, too, how old are you? Anasunguka mgumu. We shall stop counting the years. No, don't worry. Huko hakuna mtu atakuuliza how old are you? Because miaka ita koma. Bwana asifiwe. God is so good. Bwana asifiwe. So have courage in the Lord, because He loves you and He cares for you. Bwana asifiwe. So He has allowed us to live on this earth for the few years He wants us to live. Some of us will live to be age 200. Are you ready? Someone said, mimi singetaka nifike sabini. Wewe ungetaka ufike ngapi? 200. I really know you live to be 200. Someone live to 230. We have to live to enjoy the goodness of the Lord on this earth. Na akija tuende nyumbani mara moja, unajua? Tutakuwa tu transformed, tutabadilishwa tu. Bwana asifiwe. Bwana apewe sifa. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Are you the chosen one of God?
Yes.
No, the scripture says clearly, many are called, but few are chosen. Many are called, but few are chosen. I was reading another scripture from the book of Esdras, 2 Esdras. Nikasema, Esdras, Mungu anamuuliza. Anamuuliza swali, when he was praying for his people. He was praying for his people, the Israelites. Praying God, God, remember your people. Then God sent him an angel with these words. With a question, Ezra, look around. Look around. What is so precious? What is so precious on the earth? Then Ezra says, gold is precious. And then God says, yes, it's true. Gold is precious. But what is plenty on the earth? Then Ezra looked around and said, the soil is plenty. Then yes, soil is plenty. What is scarce? Then Ezra looks around and says, gold is scarce. Then God says to him, therefore, what is precious is scarce. Bwana asifiwe. Unaweza chukua udongo uende uuze. Yes, unaweza. Ukiubadilisha kuwa matofali. Unaweza. Ni kweli. Tofali moja nilienda mahali Huko kwetu tofali moja ilikuwa inauzwa shilingi 3. Shilingi 3 tofali moja. Tofali moja ni kubwa kiasi cha hii Biblia. Tofali moja. Na inauzwa shilingi 3. Ukipata gold this size, nafikiri hizo ni pesa ngapi? Utakula wajukuu wako wakuli na waachie vitukuu. So precious things are very expensive, but the common things are very easy. So you can imagine a block of brick, a brick of that size is 3 shillings. But you keep a gold that size, my friend, you are very rich. Ukiuza, ukipata market uuze, unapata pesa nyingi. Bwana asifiwe.
Amen.
Bwana asifiwe.
Amen.
So are you gold or soy? Haya. Sasa zinakuuliza swali, ujibu au ujijibu. Are you gold or soy? Then you'll tell me, none of us will want to say I'm gold. Thank you. You are gold. Then I ask you a question. Gold is mined from the soil. True or false? It comes from the soil. Now, how is it purified? How is gold purified? Through the furnace, mortar, through fire. So gold is purified by fire. That's how gold is purified. So, you want to remain gold? Nimesikia ndugu Tom akizungumza hapa mambo ya perfection. Tuliza swali. Si ni kweli? Then the answer is what? We cannot perfect ourselves, eh? It's God who perfects us, sindio?
Yes.
Sisi, kazi yetu ni kufanya nini? Kutii, be obedient, yield, stand where the Lord tells you to stand. Did you go ahead?
Yes.
You have to yield. You yield. You give yourself. Just offer yourself the way you are. Offer yourself to God. You give yourself to God. That's what we mean by yielding. You give yourself to God just the way you are, in obedience to His word. You just give yourself to Him. Then what does He do? He puts you in a furnace. Then He puts you in a furnace. And you know what happens in a furnace? Eh? Watu gani walitiwa kwa furnace? Unawajua hawa watu? Three boys walio kwa furnace. Moto umewashwa 7 times hotter than normal. Then wakarushwa huko kwa furnace. Bwana asifiwe. Huko ni moto. Furnace ni moto. Taka kuchoma matofali. Taka kuchoma matofali ya hivi vizuri. Unaweka kwa furnace. Na unawasha moto. Bwana asifiwe.
Amen.
Am I talking to people?
Yes.
I want you to get this seriously. Because some of you are in the furnace already. You are wondering why me. Why me? God, why me? Why am I going through this? Bwana asifiwe. So I'm asking a question. Why does God test us? Kwa nini Mungu hupenda kutujaribu? Remember, God does not try. God tests. God does not tempt. God does not tempt. God tests. I've said that severally. Many times I've said that. God does not tempt us. Does not tempt us. God tests us. He put us to test to prove a point. Now I want to let us look at a few things here. Then you'll understand why you are in that furnace. Bonus, if you will.
Amen.
A furnace is a good place to be. Is it true? Tell your neighbor, a furnace is a good place to be. Hey, are you sure? Are you sure what you're saying? A furnace. Eh? It's a good place to be, eh? How many people here, if you are called to go back to a furnace, you'd be willing to go? Buenas y vive. We will not be willing to go. But as for me, I would like to go there time and again. It's a good place to be, I tell you. Furnace. Buenas y vive. And God does not send anyone before takes you to a furnace. He has to take you to a furnace. Gold is tried by fire. So if you want to be sent by God, you want to be used of God, you must be willing to get into the furnace. Hallelujah.
Amen.
It's not a sweet place to be. But look at these three brothers who are put in the furnace. What happened? Immediately they were thrown into the furnace. A fourth person appeared. And Nebuchadnezzar is asking, did we put three in the furnace? Who is this fourth one? And he looks like the son of the gods. So that was not an ordinary human being. That's why Nebuchadnezzar said, he looks like the son of the gods. What as if you will? Are you getting it?
Yes.
They were hurled into the furnace. When they came out of the furnace, what happened? A decree was sent into the whole kingdom that the God of Shadrach, Meshach and Abednego should be worshipped. He is the only God who can save from fire after the furnace. Burn as if you will.
Amen.
So after the furnace, you are a different person if you go through it patiently. Burn as if you will.
Amen.
Burn up your sifa. Are you there, boys and girls? Are you there, boys and girls? God loves you. Tell your neighbor, God loves you.
God loves you.
Let me tell you, we go through some pressure in our lives. Eh? That's a kind of furnace you're going through. Some pressure. Pressure all the sides. Pressure. Pressure. Na kila mtu ana pressure yake. Na mtu ana yake. Yako ni tofauti na yako. Yako ni tofauti na ya mwingine. So, sote, we don't experience the same pressure. Hata yule naona tajiri sana. Mwende tu pole pole ukao usikilize vile anaongea. Utajua atapitia pressure. Bwana asifiwe. Utashangaa. Nilisoma hicho kitabu cha Joshua Ben Sira. Ikaniambia kwamba kila mwanadamu juu ya uso wa nchi Mungu amemgawia mzigo wake wa kubeba. So kila mwanadamu ana mzigo wa kubeba. Awe anavyo, awe hana, ana mzigo wa kubeba. That means kila mmoja wetu amegawiwa pressure yake ya kubeba. Bwana asifiwe. Za wengine ni nzito sana, ukiambiwa unashtuka. Na unaambia jina mna gani? Lakini pia yule unafikiria ni mdogo akwambia yake utashtuka pia. Sema wa. Ni waenga wakasema kitanda usicholalia ujui kunguni wake. Bwana asifiwe. Some men complained about their wives. Complained bitterly. But wengine akaambia mwenzake, bwana inaonekana wako hapo afadhali wangu. And wakasema let us exchange. Then they exchange. Yeah, they exchange. Huyo akasema nipatie wako, huyo wako ni afadhali. Yule anasema huyo wako anaonekana afadhali. Eh? Then they exchange. After 1 week, walikuwa wameinua mikono. Ni hapa yule nimezoea. Irudishio yule nimezoea. Bwana asifiwe. Kila mtu na pressure yake. Lazima una mzigo wako. Bwana asifiwe. Na kama huna mzigo unabeba, something is wrong. Something is. Bwana asifiwe. Bwana asifiwe. So why does God test us? There are many reasons why God tests us. Many, many reasons. But I just want to look at a few. Number one, God tests us to enlarge us. Unasikia je hiyo? He tests us to enlarge us. To make us increase the capacity. You know, I usually tell you here, when I was growing up, nilikuwa na ujinga mwingi sana. Ujinga wa kiroho. Ujinga wa kiroho. Niliwaambia ujinga mmoja hapa siku moja. Mimi kusalimia mtu wa kike ilikuwa ni dhambi. Ulikuwa ujinga wa kiroho, si ni kweli? Ulikuwa ni ujinga. Because I considered greeting a female as sin. So kutana tuna wewe ni kusalimie. And you know that affected me even today. Even today it has affected me. Naweza kutana na mtu wa kike. Na immediately na tunaweza kaa hata tu kazini kuwa naenda meetings na kaa nazungumza na jadili. Take an example, tumeitwa county level or sub county level for a meeting. Nakutana pale wafanyikazi wenzako, mmeketi panel, mnazungumza. Nikitoka pale I can remember the men. Tukikutania hata huko nje nakumbuka huyu tulikutania mahali fulani. But a female, I can't remember. Kwa na nitoka kwa akili immediately. That's easy. So for me to know a female, lazima tukae na yeye to interact for some time. Ndio nianze kumjua. That's why I usually say, tukikutana huko njiani naona nimepita kama gari la moshi, please greet me. I have a weakness in that area. Tusiseme tu, najifanya. Here, akikutana na wewe huko nje aweze kusalimia. Usiseme hivyo. Just greet me. Say hello. Bwana asifiwe.
Amen.
But after some time, when I started preaching, being in active ministry, ladies started coming, receiving Christ. And I would really ask God, why are you bringing ladies? Because it was sin. to me. We'll see. But eventually God taught me. He taught me. In other words, he enlarged my heart. He enlarged me to understand that this is part of the body of Christ. These people are members of the body of Christ. And they are not seen. According to me, they were seen. At Shuren Triposomana, I was very careful with them. Very careful. I didn't want them near me. But as if you will. Then I came a time, I saw people marry, and I prayed, God, don't want to get married. But I said, God, I don't want sin in my house. And then the Lord said to me, I remember very well that picture in Liona, here on Mount Liona. I remember it like it happened yesterday. Niliona kiganja cha mkono. Hiki kiganja. Hicho ndio niliona. Na sauti kafuata la, si hivyo. You must get married. See, what I consider is sin must now get into my heart and get a wife and become a wife. Bwana asifiwe. Amen. Ninyi mnacheza. Tumekuwa wajinga. Kwa miaka sio tu muda mfupi. Miaka mingi tulikuwa na ujinga wa kiroho. That's why I tell people don't be afraid to make a mistake. Make mistakes but be ready to be corrected. Because I made so many. Bwana asifiwe. Then the Lord took me to a furnace. So when I got into active ministry, I was telling my boys, was it today in the morning? I got into active ministry. Was it today? I got into active ministry at 17 years old. Active ministry. Active ministry at 17 years old. That's when I began active ministry. You understand what I mean by active ministry? 17 years old. Then those who are responding to the gospel very fast were females. Females. They were responding very fast. Kupiri wa mekiri. And those are the people who are filled by the Holy Spirit. Haraka. Liko boys. Boys wanted proofs. Another boy came to me and said, you want me to receive Jesus? I said, yes. Then I pray for me that I see Jesus. You know what I did? I laid my hand on him. Said, Jesus, this boy wants to see you. Appear to him. Then he went home. The following day, I met him. He said, did Jesus come? He said, yes, he came. He came. Kamuliza, what did he tell you? And he told me to forsake everything else and follow him. And you do exactly what he said. That boy hardened his heart. He's dead. He died. Didn't live long. He died. Bwana asifiwe. Bwana apewe sifa. God enlarged my heart to accommodate other people. When as if you will, he enlarged me. When God puts you in a furnace, one of the reasons why he's putting you to the furnace is to enlarge you, to make you big. When as if you will. When I went through the furnace, people started noticing me. People started noticing this boy has something different. This boy has something different. That I could hear wazee, old men, wazee kansano wakisema, huu kijana, ni tofauti sana vijana wengine. Tofauti sana vijana wengine. Bwana asifiwe. The Lord had enlarged me. Now ni mnajulikana. Watu wananijua, anaanza kunijua. The whole village, ikanijua. The whole village after knowing me, I earned some enemies who wanted to finish me. Physically finish me. Bwana asifiwe. Amen. Nikisikia mtu akisema nitakuua, mwangalia. Uliza wewe unajua kule nimetoka. Try your best. Bwana asifiwe. Bwana asifiwe. So God wants to enlarge you. Are you going through a type of furnace? God wants to enlarge you. Wants to make you know. If you go through it, through the furnace. Bwana asifiwe. Bwana asifiwe.
Amen.
Am I talking to people here really?
Yes.
Now, next. Why does God take us through the furnace? He takes us through the furnace to prove us and to humble us. You know, this morning I was being reminded of somebody. I don't know why, but I remember this gentleman tulifanya form 4. Yeah, alikuwa anasoma Nairobi, alikuwa anasoma Mashabani. So after form 4 we met in Nairobi. Yeah, alikuwa anakuja tu Mashabani during the holidays, tunakuwa na ushirika mzuri, tunaimba, tunaomba pamoja. Ushirika mzuri sana. And then I came to Nairobi. Now I come to Nairobi, this gentleman sote wawili tunatafuta kazi. But he comes to me and tells me, please, niombe nipate kazi. Unawezaje kuambia mtu ambaye anatafuta kazi ya kuombe upate kazi? Nikaona hilo nikamuuliza bwana, sasa unajua mimi natafuta kazi, wewe unaniambia nikuombe unatafuta kazi. How can this work out? Kasema wewe niombe tu. Najua ukiomba Mungu atasikia. Wewe omba tu Mungu atupatie kazi. Mwambie sawa, tutakuombea. Then I pray God to give me the grace to pray for him. Because what he's looking for is what I'm looking for. So God, give me the grace to pray for this gentleman. Then I prayed. His brother is late today, pastor. So I prayed, God, give him a job. And you know, the answer came. This thing I was reminded today in the morning in the bathroom. Then when I prayed, Kamaliza Kumba, another came. Do you know what the Lord said to me? He said to me, you will get a job before him. So Kamaliza Mungu, why? Well, because this man is very selfish. But wewe takupa kazi kwa sababu kuna watu wengi utasaidia. That was a very rude answer. Very rude answer. Singeenda kumwambia hiyo. Hiyo nilinyamaza nayo. Sema wah. Hii ni hatari. And for sure this gentleman died without a stable job. Lakini kupita mtihani alipita vizuri kushinda mimi. But he died without a stable job. Fanya kibarua hapa, isha, fanya job like that. But God gave me a job mysteriously. Mimi ambaye sikujulikana na watu wakubwa. I got a job, nikaenda college mysteriously. Na nika train fees ikalipwa bila mimi kutoa hata senti moja kwa mfuko. That was a mysterious thing. Then after I got a job, I tell you, I have never lived alone. Nimeishi na watu. Toka nilipopewa hiyo kazi, nimeishi na watu. Nikilisha watu. Hata wengine wenu ni mashahidi. Bwana asifiwe. So nimekuwa nikilisha nikikumbuka Mungu aliniambia nitasaidia watu wengi. So ninavumilia tu. Watu wengine wanafika mahali wanashangaa, why are you allowing this? Then I remember. Buenas, if you will.
Amen.
God takes us through the furnace to prove us. He wants to prove your faith in Him. He wants to prove it. And to humble you. Another thought came to me in the morning. Again, nikakumbushwa mtu fulani. Na neno likasema ndani yangu, kama huyu mtu angepewa kazi, mimi nilipomaliza shule, angekuwa na kiburi sana. Lakini Mungu kumnyima kazi ilikuwa kumnyenyekeza. Sasa nikashindwa. So God does some things, just say, unahangaika hivi, kumbe His purpose is to humble somebody. Kuna watu wengine kati yetu kama wangefanikiwa tu immediately, wangekanyagia watu chini. Lakini sasa Mungu naye anaona huwa huyu mtu ana kiburi, kiburi chake hiki atakanyagia watu chini. So let acha nimfinye hapa hivi. Alafu Mungu anakufinya hapa. Alafu nakuwa humble. Bwana asifiwe. Unakuwa humble. Unajua Paul angekuwa na kiburi kwa sababu when he got converted, Mungu alionekana kwa Paul kwa fujo. Na akampatia siri nyingi ambazo hakupatia wengine. Then Mungu akatuma mjumbe wa shetani kwa mwili wa Paul. Kaweka mwiba ndani ya mwili wa Paul. And Paul prayed 3 times. Aondolewe huo mwiba. Lakini Mungu alikataa. The purpose was to humble him. To make him humble. So some things God allows them in our lives to humble us. To wake a chin. Nijue, dunia hii si yangu. Bwana asifiwe. Otherwise, ukitoka tu huko chini umepewa kila kitu, kila kitu, kila kitu. Angalia watoto wa matajiri hajui kuna maskini. Akiona maskini wana sneer, they sneer. Sio lazima. Na fiole. Wanasema kwamba they are lazy. They are poor because they are lazy. Naona mtoto wa tajiri hakuna bidii naye. Ni vile tu baba yake na nini mali. So ya naona ako hard working na yule wa mtoto maskini is lazy. Because they have never gone through those stages. Bwana asifiwe. Ukizaliwa tu kwa raha utadharau watu. So Mungu anakuruhusu ingie motoni kidogo. Ujaribiwe kidogo so that unyenyekee. You humble. God humbles you. Bwana asifiwe. Hebu tusome hiki kitabu. Deuteronomy. Is it Deuteronomy or Deuteronomy? Deuteronomy. Deuteronomy chapter 8. God is saying something to the children of Israel through his servant Moses. 15 and 16. Inasema. Let's start from 14. When your heart is lifted up and you forget the Lord your God who brought you out of the land of Egypt from the house of bondage, who led you through the great and terrible wilderness in which were fiery or fiery serpents and scorpions, and thirsty land where there was no water, who brought water for you out of the flinty rock, who fed you in the wilderness with manna, which your fathers did not know, that he might humble you, that he might test you to do you good in the end. So why was God taking the Israelites into dry land, into the wilderness, where there was no water, where there was no food, where there was no meat. Why was he taking them through that wilderness? The purpose was to humble them and test them so that he may do them good in the end. Bonus if you. So the purpose of God is to do you good in the end. But some things must die. So what is the opposite of humility? Pride, eh? So pride must die. Well, as if you will. So God must kill pride by taking you through a furnace. Must kill pride. Because his purpose is to do you good in the end. So are we going through some struggles in life? There are things God is killing in us so that he might do us good in the end. Bwana asifiwe.
Amen.
Bwana asifiwe.
Amen.
Suffering increases God's power in us. Suffering increases God's power in us. Bwana asifiwe.
Amen.
Hey, does that make sense, really? Suffering increases God's power in us. Is it true, really? Let's read. Psalms 102, verse 23. Inasema. Psalms Zaburi 102, verse 23. Inasema. He weakened my strength in the way. He shortened my days. God weakened his strength in the way and shortened his days. So God must weaken your strength. You know, I was very, very strong. Let me tell you another ujinga mwingine wa kiroho. Are you listening?
Yes.
Nani huyo analia? Hebu nikuambie ujinga mwingine wa kiroho. I believed as a minister of the gospel. When I stand on the pulpit, I preach according to the guidance of the Holy Spirit. I don't have to have any notes anywhere. Don't have to write notes that I'll be preaching from these notes. Don't have to. I'm a servant of God, filled of the Holy Spirit. Therefore, I preach as the Spirit leads me. Those are words I uttered one day. Right? Then, when you know what happened? In the night, the Lord came to me. I love this Jesus, you know. He liked to correct me. So he came to me in the night. Maybe what you said is wrong. Because that's what you're going to do in the future. So he made me understand that the writing is not a sin. You see, that's what I'm doing now. I have notes here. I have notes. But those days I said it shows you are not spiritual. Ujinga wa grow. Ni mwingi bwana. Ujinga grow ni mwingi. So, gazema, nikaambia mwenzangu, if you write notes, it means you are not spiritual. A spiritual person preaches from the Spirit. The Lord comes and rebukes me in the night. Tells me what you said is not right. Because that's what you'll do in future. Then he said to me, take care not to say what you'll do. Not to oppose what you'll do in the future. Say to me, take care not to oppose what you'll do in the future. Let's get your money. Take care not to oppose what you'll do in the future. Bwana asifiwe. Unajua, I came to realize, unajua, when you want to preach or you are preparing to preach, sometimes God prepares you in advance and he gives you what to say in advance. If you don't write them down, it'll vanish. Bwana asifiwe. Because in the process, God keeps on talking to you as his servant keeps on talking to you. In a day, God can speak to you very many times about different things. Bwana asifiwe. Are you getting me? So God weakened my strength on the way. Let's look at 2 Corinthians. Now that's Paul talking now. 2 Corinthians chapter 12. Second Corinthians chapter 12. Let's read verse 5. Verse 5 in the same one. Of such a one I'll boast. That's Paul is talking of a man who was taken up into the heavens, the third heaven. Such one was caught up to the third heaven, right? Then in the same one, verse 5 in the same one. Of such one I will boast, yet of myself I will not boast except in my infirmities. Paul is talking about boasting, right? Aye. Now verse 7 to 10, in a summary, unless I should be exalted above measure by the abundance of the revelations, a thorn in the flesh was given me, a messenger of Satan to befriend me, lest I be exalted above measure. That is now pride. Now, a messenger was sent into Paul's body to torment him. And the purpose of the messenger was to prevent pride in Paul, because a lot of revelations had been given to him. Alikuwa amepata ufunuo mwingi. Mungu amemfunulia mambo mengi ya siri za ndani. God had spoken to Paul many times. Now, because of those revelations, is it Paul ndiye anazungumza kwamba hatutakufa sisi wote, bali kwa kufumba na kufumbuliwa kwa jicho tutafanywaje? Tageuzwa. Sini Paula anazungumza hiyo. Unaona wani ufunua baa una mwanafunzi mwingine wa Yesu. Then Paul ndiye anatuambia vile mwili utabadilishwa. Sio ni ufunua baa una mwanafunzi mwingine wa Yesu. So you are given very high revelations. Now, kama mwanadamu wa kawaida angejisifu, sema mimi ndio nimefunuliwa makubwa kushinda. I was talking to my family and saying I had a prophet. Nilikuwa nasikiliza prophet fulani. Siniulize ni jina gani. And I'm not trying to discredit him. But I had the prophet akisema, any prophet who does not tell you what names mean to you and what they how they affect you is not a prophet. Nana ya metia muri yeye tu ndiye prophet. Hao wengine si prophets. Hao ni bandia. So nikasema, you see, that's a mistake we make as preachers. We make such mistakes. Because hiyo area yake amepewa. naweza kukushambulia jina na kwa hili jina lako litatoka kwa fulani litatoka kwa fulani na liko na maana hii na hili ndivyo linakuaffect katika maisha yako. Hiyo ni area yake amepewa by the Holy Spirit. Now prophet mwingine naye amepewa area yake ya cooperate. So you can't tell, can't say huyu amepewa area hii. Yes, he prophet, where you prophet? What any prophet, but the areas of operation are different. Bwana asifiwe.
Amen.
Bwana asifiwe.
Amen.
Is there any other person here? We have so many teachers of the word in this church. Is there any other teacher who teaches like me? Does that qualify that person to be a teacher and me not a teacher? Or it qualifies me to be a teacher and that you are other one not a teacher of the word? We all serve different according to the grace that we are given. Bwana asifiwe. So unakuta mtu kama huyu ameingiwa na hiyo pride kishaingia. Inapiga nguvu za Mungu zinarudi chini. Have you ever known that? Bwana asifiwe. So unaona Paul hapa anasema ili asijisifu kupita kiasi. Mjumbe wa shetani, and God allowed that servant of the devil, that agent of the devil, to get into Paul's body to humble him. Bwana asifiwe. To kill pride. So ukiwa mgonjwa mahali kwa mwili, ukienda kujisifu na unasikia uchungu. It is there to humble you. Bwana asifiwe. You see, there's another gentleman, I think I've once said it here. And the gentleman said to us, that if you, ukiwa mgonjwa, wewe unadhambi. Mtu wa Mungu atakiwa kuwa na ugonjwa. Mtu wa Mungu hawi mgonjwa. Nikaona huu ni ujinga wa kiroho. Huu likuwa ujinga wa kiroho katika wewe ndugu. Mtu wa Mungu hana ugonjwa. Na ugonjwa upati mtu wa Mungu. Ukiona ugonjwa umekupata, kuna dhambi umefanya, tubu dhambi. Namwangalia. Nikaona huo ni ujinga wa kiroho. So you know, after some days, alikuwa amechapwa na homa mbaya sana. Alikuwa amefungana. Kufungana kabisa, homa imemchapa. Nauliza ndugu wa mtu wa Mungu, leo ulifanya dhambi gani una ugonjwa? Huu ni ujinga wa kiroho. Bwana asifiwe. There are some people who have never fallen sick for very many years. And when they see people fall sick, they wonder why. Bwana asifiwe. There are some people tangu anze ministry alikuwa tu blessed, pesa zina flow tu. So akiona a struggling child like yours wanasema there is no God there. Because God provides. Me, God provides for me. So when they find you struggling, sema, there is no God here. Go where God is. Then when I talk about the way of God, he's only to find is the devil ruling. Bwana asifiwe. Bwana apewe sifa. That is pride. Pride comes in when someone has not gone through the furnace. Kiburi ni kingi. Anakuwa na kiburi kingi sana. Bwana asifiwe. But when you go through the furnace, my friend, ni unaelewa. Unafika, unakuta mtu wako na shida fulani, unakumbuka your furnace. Like, yeah, my brother understand. I went through this. Bwana asifiwe. Bwana apewe sifa. Mtu aniambia kwamba yule hajawahi fiwa, hawezi comfort yule amefiwa. Is it true? Yule hajawahi fiwa. Hawezi comfort yule amefiwa. Bwana, when you lose your loved one, Nangia state ingine bobu. Baya sana. Only a person who has ever been there can talk to you. Bwana asifiwe. Person who has been there can talk to you. Nausikia na ongea kitu. Bwana apewe sifa. Mchungaji alikuwa naenda. Mtu wa kanisani kwake amepata msiba, naenda na comfort, anausoma maandiko na upiri maandiko na mhubiri anamfundisha, anampia moyo. Paka mtu anasikia kweli, mchungaji amezungumza, anapata nguvu, nasema. Siku moja mchungaji akafiwa. Mchungaji alilia, akalia, akalia. So washirika wakaja kumcomfort, wakasema mchungaji wewe ndio umekuwa ukitutia moyo. Kitutia nguvu. Eh? Kwe na mochukua nguvu mchungaji. Simama imara. Mchungaji kawambia, ah, uchungu huu nasikia. Sio kama ule mulikuwa mnasikia. Wangu nasikia. That's why they say experience is the best. Best teacher. Yusi mchungaji alikuwa na comfort watu. Yeye yeah, alikuwa hajawahi pitia hiyo njia. Sasa alipopitia kaona ai wa watu hawasikii vile nasikia. Ah tu nilikuwa na comfort, hawako na uchungu kama huu wangu. Bwana asifiwe.
Amen.
Bwana apewe sifa.
Amen.
So when you go through a furnace, you are able to strengthen those who are going through it. Bwana asifiwe.
Amen.
Now verse 8 inasema concerning this thing, I pleaded with the Lord 3 times that it might depart from me. And he said to me, my grace is sufficient to you, for my strength is made perfect in weakness. That's God saying. Therefore, most gladly I will rather boast in my infirmities than that the power of Christ may rest upon me. Therefore, I take pleasure in infirmities, in reproaches, in needs, in persecution, in distress, for Christ's sake. For when I am weak, then I am strong. Bwana asifiwe. Now, in that weakness, Paul learned one, to get rid of pride. Alitoa kiburi. Number 2, he learned to depend on God. When you have a weakness in yourself, then you learn to depend on the strength of someone else. I had to depend on the strength of who? Of God. What has he doing? Number 3, he learned to rejoice in trials. Wakati kwa katikati ya majaribu mengi, can you really smile? Hata joy wa inapotea, sio? Furaha inaenda mbali na wewe. Ona, now this one. Needs the best way to handle this one is to frown. But Paul says here, therefore, I take pleasure in infirmities, in reproaches, in needs, in persecution, in distress, for Christ's sake. For when I am weak, then I am strong. So he learned to rejoice in trials. Well, as if you will. That's what the Lord wants to see in us. And when we approach it that way, then the power of God increases in us. The Lord is saying to Paul, my power, my grace is sufficient to you, for my strength is made perfect in weakness. When I'm weak, I depend on God. Right? Has anyone here experienced a dry spell spiritually? A dry spell. You have not experienced a dry spell. Welcome to hide every time. Eh? Yes, hallelujah. Yes, Yes, Jesus. Hallelujah. Sisi ufika saa unakuta hiyo hata hallelujah haiko karibu. Imeenda, imeenda bye. Hiyo ndio tunaita dry spell. Unajaribu kujicheck. Do I still have the spirit in me? Unasikia kama alikwenda. Hiyo ndio tunaita dry spell. When you reach there, my friend, you can easily confuse that the Lord has forsaken me. Nasema Mungu ameniacha sasa. Mimi ameenda. Bado wengine tumezoea. So you are in that dry spell. And Pastor says, today we receive the word from Pastor. Na uko in a dry spell. Hiyo ni majaribu. Unatamani tu basi ni ungefuka hiyo mkutano. Unasema tu basi ungefunga huo mkutano. Tuende tu nyumbani. Sasa kuniambia kuhubiri nao. Hii ni mambo gani? That is the time I say, Lord, now take over. I have nothing to say. Please take over. And when I say, Lord, take over, nikisimama tu kwa pulpit, pa! Nekuja. Because I'm now depending on not in my strength. Bwana asifiwe.
Amen.
Bwana apewe sifa.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
May I finish this? Bwana asifiwe.
Amen.
I asked a question. Are you called or chosen? And then the scripture says, many are called, but few are chosen. Maybe I have not read that scripture properly yet. Bado umechambua hiyo maandiko. Does it say a few or a few? Says a few or a few. Few are chosen. Eh? And we have a few. And we have few. We have a little. And we have little. Those are two different words. A few and few are different. Are you aware? Alors, nasoma Kiingereza, mnajua? A few. A few means some amount. Some amount, isn't it? Few means almost nothing. Then Jesus says, many are called, but few are chosen. So almost no good. Is chosen. Unasikiaje? So that's why anasema ni wachache wanaona njia nyembamba. So compared to the population of those who profess Christ as their Lord, compared to that population, you find a very minute number have decided to follow Christ truthfully. So tunaweza kuwa 5,000 in the church, but ukute only 5 have committed their lives completely to Christ. Those are the few. Bwana asifiwe. Bwana asifiwe. Affliction separates the chosen from the called. In other words, I want to say, a furnace separates the chosen from the called. Let me see the book of Isaiah, chapter 48. God said something to the children of Israel. 48 verse 10. Verse 10, the Lord is saying, behold, I have refined you, but not as silk. I have tested you in the furnace of affliction. The Lord has refined you, but not as silver. I have tested you in the furnace of affliction. Now let's go to the book of Revelations. Book of Revelation. Revelation chapter 17. Chapter 17 verse 14. And I said, this will make war with the Lamb. You make war with the Lamb. Verse 13 in Azema, these are of one mind, and they will give their power and authority to the beast. Then he says, this will make war with the Lamb, and the Lamb will overcome them, for he is the Lord of lords and King of kings. And those who are with him are called, chosen, and faithful. So those who will fight with the Lamb are those who are wicked, the beast. But we shall fight alongside the Lamb. We, the chosen, will fight alongside the Lamb. Because we were refined and tested in the furnace of affliction. Bwana asifiwe.
Amen.
So as a child of God, to be chosen, you need to be refined through the furnace of affliction. So ikifika wakati wa furnace, hapo ndio unajua wewe Mungu mtu kweli ameamua kumfuata Yesu. Bwana asifiwe.
Amen.
Hapa church tukitaka kujua nani mshiriki, wacha shida ipatikane hapa. Wengine watakimbia waende. Na wale watabaki ndio tutajua hawa ndio washiriki wa hapa. Bwana asifiwe.
Amen.
Shida upatikana makanisani, si mnajua? Shida upatikana makanisani. Tom taught me, Tom taught me that the church goes through three circles. Circle number one is gathering. Remember you taught me that? It's gathering. Circle number one is gathering. Right? About the nine that are billing jiri uko inje uijilisti watu wanakuja, wanakuja, nasema the church is growing. The church is growing. Tunafurahia. The church is growing. Then tunafika stage ingine naitwa safety. Asa shida zimetokea kwa kanisa. Safety. Watu wanakuwa sifted. Wengine wanatoka wanaenda. Nasema now what happened? Naonekana mchungaji na kasoro. Kwa nini watu wanakuja wakienda? Right? Nafika stage ya safety. Kuna watu wanatoka wanafanya nini? Wanaenda. Then nafika stage ya maturity. Sasa wale wamebaki wanakuwa matured in the spirit. Bwana asifiwe. They become sons of God. They become equal to God. They are mature. They are thinking, their reasoning is not childish. They reason like mature people. They are seeing far. They are seeing ahead. They are looking at what is above, not what is on earth. Those are mature people. Bwana asifiwe.
Amen.
Bwana apewe sifa.
Amen.
So, through affliction, ndio unajulikana if you are chosen or not. Through sifting, ndio tunajua are these members of this church or they are just passing. Bwana asifiwe.
Amen.
Nasikia brother Tony akisema hapa kama tunahubiri hii injili toka Januari mpaka Januari na bado mnakuja tu kweli nyinyi ni mwashiriki wa hika. Nasikia brother Tony akisema kitu kama hiki. So my good friends, unajulikana through the furnace. Hata Mungu anakujua through the furnace. Shall Peter through the furnace if you are still calling on Jesus truthfully. Toa kwa moyo, Mungu hata kiangalia moyo wako, naona moyo wako unalia tu, Mungu nakupenda. Ni wale naliwe, you are my Lord. Mungu anaona huyu mtu ni wangu kweli. Chosen. Anapiga muhuri wa chosen. So wewe ukipita mahali, mapepo yakikuona anasema chosen. Chosen is passing. Chosen is passing here. Haikuwa na shtuka. Demons are afraid of you because you are chosen. Once you are chosen, the demons will know you. They know you very well that you are chosen. Demons know the chosen of God. Those are the ones they try to attack every day. And we defeat them by the blood of the Lamb. Bwana asifiwe. Bwana asifiwe. Are you chosen of God? Tell your neighbor, I'm chosen of God. Are you afraid to say that? Say it, I'm chosen of God. Confidently, you say, I'm chosen. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Our spirit testifies with our hearts that we belong to God. The spirit of God testifies with my heart that I belong to God. So I'm not afraid to say, I'm chosen of God. Because that's what the spirit tells me. Bwana asifiwe. Bwana apewe sifa. Let me finish with this one. The furnace teaches us to obedience. Furnace teaches us obedience. Bwana asifiwe. People who have never gone through a furnace are so stubborn. They are as stubborn as a mule. Do you know, ukitaka kuwa mule, what you do? Can I teach you? Do you know what a mule is, kwanza? A mule is the offspring of a donkey and a horse. And you know, it's a mule. Offspring of a donkey and a horse. That is the what? The half caste. Half caste to a dog and a mule. And a horse. And I to a mule. Do you know, a mule is a very stubborn animal. Very stubborn. Then God says, if you become as stubborn as a mule, what shall I do? You know what God said? I will break your neck. So that's how a mule is killed. You break its neck. Bwana asifiwe. So if you become stubborn, in other words, disobedient, what God does is to break your neck. Proverbs chapter 29, verse 1, inasema, whoever is corrected many times and does not yield, will break or will be broken. There will be no remedy. Well, as if you will. A furnace produces obedience. Let's see Hebrews. That's the last verse I'm reading, unless the Spirit tells me otherwise. Hebrews chapter 6. Hebrews chapter 6 verse 5. Not chapter 6. Chapter 5 verse 8. Chapter 5 verse 8. Nasema. Though he was a son, yet he learned obedience by the things which he suffered. He was a son, but learned obedience by the things he suffered. So the writer of Hebrews is talking about Jesus. He learned to obey his father by the things he suffered. So God allows some things to come into our lives. We suffer some things in our lives so as to learn obedience to his voice. Bwana asifiwe.
Amen.
That's why I tell people, just obey God before he forces you to obey. Don't let him force you to obey. Because if he does, you'll not like it. Bwana asifiwe. Brothers and sisters, I finish here by saying that going through a furnace has its benefits to us if we go through it patiently, faithfully. If we go through that furnace patiently and faithfully, there are benefits, so many benefits. Unaonaje Mungu amekupiga muhuri chosen. Unajua hakuna mtu atakuona, lakini mapepo yataona. Mapepo yataona chosen. Sasa kuangalia chosen. How many times do we pass places? And brother Pastor Tom will tell you. How many times do we pass places? Nasikia mtu anashtukia na, "Hey pastor, habari yako pastor." Na huyo mtu hujamwambia wewe ni pastor. Hujaongea na yeye, wewe unapita tu. Sometimes unapita njiani unatoka kwa shughuli yako, mtu anasema tu anakwambia, "Pastor niombe." What is wrong? Then it means there's a spiritual writing on our foreheads which those people see. They see it. Niwaambia mapango pa kazi, watu walianza tu kuniita pastor, pastor, pastor. I never identified myself to anybody by being a pastor, no. I just say my name is so and so. Full stop. And if you move with me, wherever I go, that's how I identify myself. I introduce myself as so and so. I don't introduce my title. Then all of a sudden, where the pastor? Where the pastor? Why? There must be some writings they see. So there are those spiritual writings that God writes on your forehead. As a child of God, he has chosen. And I think on your forehead, chosen. Chosen of God. And the demons will see those writings. And they will try to attack you. Mtu anajiuliza, why am I attacked every time? Why am I being attacked like this? There's something very special with you. That's why you're being attacked. Very special. Don't get scared. Know that you are very special. There's a writing the demons are seeing. So they want to distract you by attacking you so that you lose focus. Hiyo maandishi ifutike. Bwana asifiwe. So be bold when you go through that furnace. Be bold. Rejoice when you go through it. Rejoice in those trials. Ukisikia unalemewa, unasema, "Lord, give me the grace to withstand. Give me the patience. Strengthen me, O Lord." And God will strengthen you. And he'll give you the grace to go through that furnace. When you come out, wakati Daniel alitoka kwa tundu la simba, what happened? Mungu amefunga simba midomo, haingeweza kumrarua. Falme alipo kuja akaita Daniel, tumishi wa Mungu aliye hai. Je, Mungu wako amekulinda? Daniel akasema, "Falme, uishi milele. Mungu wangu aliona sina hatia, akafunga midomo ya simba." And the king was very happy because he loved Daniel, but he was under pressure. You know, the subjects can really force a president to do things he didn't want to do. So, wakati alitolewa, wale walisema kwamba atupwe huko, waka pressurize the king, waka kusanywa na jamii zao zote, watoto, wanaume, mabibi, wote, pum, kwa simba. Na tunaambiwa katika maandiko, simba wali wararua before wafike on the ground. Then the king wrote a decree. Anasema, "The God of Daniel shall be worshipped in this nation. When you come out of that furnace, your God shall be worshipped." Bwana asifiwe. Your God shall be. And people will want to identify themselves with your God. Bwana asifiwe. Bwana asifiwe. Wanasikia watu wakitestify kwa makanisa mengine nikisikiza kwa TV. Nasema, "The God of prophets." Hizi yawari kusikia mkisema the God of. Wani mimi sina Mungu. Mbana zibiwe. Nasikia kusema the God of. Lakini kuuliza that prophet, what he went through before he became what he is. Watu ongea kuhusu Prophet TB Joshua, it's a man I love. I've never met him face to face, but I've met him in the spiritual realm. Tumezungumza. Bwana asifiwe. He has even come to Kenya to visit me. Huyu jamaa anaanza kujisifia. This is a reality. If my wife was here, I would tell you it's true. I told her, TB Joshua came. Bwana asifiwe. When you come out of that furnace, si Mungu wako atajulikana. Mungu wako atajulikana. So you should not be scared. Don't be afraid of the furnace. Go through it boldly. Each one of us has his or her furnace. We are going through those furnaces. Go through it peacefully, patiently. Some process your furnace takes longer than others. Others take shorter time. Others take long. It depends to the intensity of the blessing God has kept for you. Bwana asifiwe. Do you expect my furnace to be like yours? Mine can be longer. Mine can be longer. Because what I carry, mimi na Mungu ndio tunajua. Nyinyi mnaniona tu. Naona tu kana ka simple man. Kani kana tushindia nini? Na kushindia vingi. Kianza kuhesabu utashtuka. Lakini we just look at it. So when I'm going through a furnace, sometimes furnace ingine inanifikisha mahali ya kunitia aibu. Sema aibu ndio hiyo. Nakuja. God, take away shame from me. And God comes in and tia nguvu. Bwana asifiwe. Don't be afraid to go through a furnace. It is important that you go through it. If you want to have those writings on your forehead, chosen of God, you must go through a furnace. Bwana asifiwe. The intention of God is to do you good in the end. Bwana asifiwe. Naomba tusimame. As we sing this chorus, shall just make a short prayer. A short prayer, we are going to tell God, give me the grace and the patience to go through the furnace. Just make that prayer. God, give me the grace and the patience to go through the furnace. For when you come out of that furnace, my brother, my sister, your God will be known. Mungu wako atajulikana.
Thank you.
patience to come to the highest of Jesus. Lord, we ask for the grace. We ask for the grace and the patience, Lord. As we come through the furnace, Lord Jesus, we go through it patiently, Lord. Lord Jesus, we shall not give up. We shall not give up. We shall not give up. We shall not give up, oh Lord. Give us the grace, Lord Jesus, and the patience, oh dear Lord Jesus, to go through the furnace, Lord, to experience the furnace, oh Lord Jesus. Lord, I pray, and we shall not quit. We shall not give up, oh Lord Jesus. We shall not give up, oh Jesus. Oh Jesus, help us not to give up, Lord. Help us, Lord Jesus Christ, for you are the cancer of our situation. You know why we are going through the furnace? You understand why we go through the furnace? Your intention, Lord Jesus, is to do us good. We ask for your Father, help us, Lord. Help us, Lord Jesus Christ, that as we go through the furnace, Lord Jesus, we shall go through it patiently. Patiently, Lord Jesus Christ, give us the grace. Give us the grace. Give us the grace, Lord. Give us the grace, Lord. Give us the grace. Himself unto his people. We commit our lives unto you today. Lord, we are asking that you give us the grace and the patience, Lord, to go through the furnaces we are in patiently, awaiting for what you intend to do in our lives, Lord. We pray today, dear Father, strengthen us, Lord Jesus. Each one of us is going through a thing, going through different furnaces. Father, I ask for your grace to be upon them. Give them the grace to go through this trial, these temptations, Lord. Help them, Lord Jesus, Father, to go through a furnace. The furnace you put them in, Lord, I pray, help them to go through patiently and come out victoriously and glorify your name and say for sure, the Lord Jesus saw me through.
For they glorify your name, Lord Jesus Christ. I pray, dear Father, you'll hold their hearts, Lord Jesus, and take them out victoriously. Father, victoriously, that we may glorify your great name. Father, I pray in the name of Jesus, touch their lives now. Father, give them the grace. Father, strengthen them, Lord Jesus. Father, that they may go through this furnace patiently, Lord Jesus, and faithfully, truthfully, Lord Jesus. I pray, dear Father, help us, Lord. Help us, Lord. We rely on you, Lord Jesus. We depend on you. Our strength can't do us nothing. Our strength can't help us, Lord. Father, it is your strength we rely on, Lord. I pray, dear Father, touch your people. Touch your people, Lord. Touch your people, Lord Jesus. Reveal yourself unto us, that you may know that you're the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords. We thank you, dear Father. Those with different kinds of needs, we are asking the Lord Jesus, you'll touch them, Lord Jesus, at the point of their need. Father, touch them, Lord Jesus, and provide for them. Give them an answer to the questions they have. We are asking for answers, Lord Jesus, to the questions we have. Father, we have so many questions in our hearts. We are asking for answers from you. Lord, give us answers. Give us answers, Lord Jesus, to the questions we have, Lord. Lord, give us the answers. Some of us are asking, why me? And others asking, why should it happen to me? Others are asking, why? What sin have I committed? Others are wondering what is happening around them. Lord, we are asking for answers. We are asking for answers, Lord Jesus. Speak to us. Speak to our souls. Speak to our spirits, Lord, that you may glorify your name. We thank you and we bless you, mighty God of heaven. Thank you for your blessing. Thank you for your love. Thank you for your care. Lord, heal the sick in our midst. We command healing in their bodies now. We cast out every sickness, every kind of disease. We command it out of their bodies now. Out in the name of Jesus. I command that sickness out of their bodies in the name of Jesus Christ. Those things that have been planted in people's bodies, they move like objects in the people's bodies. I command them out in the name of Jesus Christ. I command them out, out in the name of Jesus. I rebuke them. I command them out of their bodies in the mighty name of Jesus. Those objects that live in their bodies, I command them out in their bodies. Out of their bodies in the name of Jesus. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Hallelujah. Touch them, Lord Jesus. Set them free. Deliver them now, Lord Jesus. We give you praise and glory. Bless us now and forever. Let our homes be blessed. Let our houses be blessed. Let our families be blessed. We pray for blessings in our families. Blessings and harmony in our families. Lord Jesus, I pray for blessings, harmony, and unity. Lord, we shall give you praise and glory. We honor you and we praise you today. Thank you, Father. Be with us now and forever. Even as we part from here now, Lord, be with us now and forever. Bind us together with the cords of love, cords that cannot be broken. We thank you and we bless you. Thank you, Lord. Let the Spirit of God fill our lives. Wherever we go in our homes, wherever we go in the place of work, Lord, we are asking that the Spirit of God will fill our hearts. We shall flow in the Spirit of God. We shall move in the Spirit of God. The anointing of the Lord Jesus will continually flow in our lives. We shall glorify you day and night because you're our Father. We thank you. We bless you. In Jesus' name we pray. May the grace of Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit, and forevermore. Amen. God bless you all. God bless you, meet at 3 o'clock.